Hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technologue. I'm back with a very interesting video today. Today we're going to compare the iPhone 13 with Sony A7C. So as bizarre as it sounds, we are going to compare the cameras between the iPhone 13, which is a smartphone, and a dedicated full frame mirrorless camera, which is the Sony A7C. I'm very excited about this comparison and let's just get to it. Alright, right off the bat, first up, let's talk about the camera hardware. So iPhone 13 comes with a couple of cameras. First up, it has a 12 megapixel normal wide angle camera and another 12 megapixel ultra wide angle camera. On the other hand, the Sony A7C works a little bit differently. It depends upon the lens that you have. Now I have a Tamron 28 to 75 lens. So basically I have a range from 28 millimeters to 75 millimeters. Now the iPhone's main camera is 26 millimeters and the ultra wide angle camera is even wider than that. So yes, we are only going to compare the main camera of the iPhone 13 with the Sony A7C at 28 millimeters, because that's the most fairest comparison that I could come up with the equipment that I have. Let's go ahead and compare the photos. Now I have edited all of these photos and I've tried to match the look so that it becomes difficult for you guys to pick which one is from the iPhone and which one is from the Sony. We're gonna do a blind test and after every photo I'll tell you which one is which. I've got my laptop over here. I'm gonna open up the photos and let's go over them one by one, shall we? All right, first up, we've got this very interesting photo. I'm pretty sure most of you are going to get it right, like which is the iPhone and which is the Sony A7C. Most of you will get it. So here we go. The photo on the right is the iPhone 13 and the photo on the left is the Sony A7C. Now, if we talk about the major differences, iPhone 13's photo is definitely over-sharpened over here and the HDR is very, very aggressive. That's because iPhones use a lot of computational photography. They click multiple photos, multiple frames and merge them into one for that HDR look. So you definitely get the HDR look over here, which is over sharpened and over processed. On the other hand, the Sony A7C is a bit more natural and that's what I do prefer, like a natural look. Alright, next up we have this photo of the plant and I'm pretty sure that here as well you will be able to tell the difference between the iPhone 13 and Sony A7C. The photo on the right is from the Sony A7C and the photo on the left is from the iPhone 13. The background blur is much more prominent from the Sony camera because of the full frame sensor and also because of the lens. The sensor is quite bigger on the Sony A7C and that's why you get that natural background blur, which just looks awesome. Apart from the depth of field, the photo is actually very similar to Sony A7C and it's a great photo from the iPhone 13. The iPhone did a very good job over here in terms of the dynamic range and also in terms of the detail level. So yeah, props to the iPhone 13 because it clicked a great photo. Next up, we have a human portrait shot. Alright, so here we have Anurag Joshi looking very fine. One photo is from the iPhone 13 and one photo is from the Sony A7C. Which one is which? The photo on the left is from Sony A7C and the photo on the right is from the iPhone 13. This was a very close round because of the portrait mode on iPhone 13. Portrait mode makes the background blur and that's why it gets kind of confusing. But it gets easier as well because of the details on the face. The details on the face are much more clearer and much better from the Sony A7C. And that's bound to happen again because of the larger sensor. The iPhone kind of softens the face, kind of washes out all the details. And that is bound to happen because of computational photography. Here we have one more portrait photo of me looking like a potato. The one on the right is from the Sony A7C and the one on the left is from the iPhone 13. Again, the same story over here. iPhone 13 has lesser details as compared to the Sony A7C. And the Sony A7C photo is a bit more natural. But again, one point to note over here is that the iPhone 13 is not that far behind. It does a great job at portrait mode and thumbs up for that. Now let's move on to some interesting low light shots. First up, we have this awesome shot of Cafe Al Forno's LED logo sign. The one on the left is shot from the iPhone 13 and one on the right is shot from the Sony A7C. Now you will notice that the iPhone has a flare problem. Like the Al Forno logo on this picture is imprinted in air. It's not there in real life. It's just the lens flare. And that is very, very annoying. But apart from that, both the photos are very good actually. The iPhone does a fairly good job in low light scenarios. Next up, we have this low light portrait shot. The one on the right is from the Sony A7C and the one on the left is from the iPhone 13. Again, the iPhone 13 is not that far behind. It does a very good job in terms of low light portrait shots as well. Now, fun fact, this photo was not shot in portrait mode. It was shot in normal mode on the iPhone 13 and it did a very good job. iPhone 13 is actually very good at clicking photos. Now, to make make this video interesting, we posted a couple of blind tests on Twitter and Instagram. And to our surprise, majority of the people did choose iPhone 13 over Sony A7C. Like in the blind test, they picked the computational photography photo because that photo is much brighter, much sharper, and just looks better to the eye. The Sony A7C photo is much more natural, but if you put a blind test, people will choose the computational photography photo, and that's just how it is. So yeah, those results were very interesting and we were surprised by them. Now one thing to consider over here is that iPhone 13 is point and shoot. You do not need to import your photos into a computer. You can shoot from the iPhone 13, edit the photo on iPhone 13 and upload it to your favorite social media platform instantly. That convenience is unparalleled, and the iPhone or any smartphone for that matter is very convenient in that aspect. Now this video will be incomplete without a video test. Alright, this is a very quick video test with the Sony A7C and the iPhone 13. Both of them are shooting at 1080p 30 frames per second. Now you guys let me know about the video quality from both of these devices, like from the camera and the iPhone as well. The exact same lighting setup, everything is the same, and I'm going to be switching the audio between both of these devices. I'm pretty sure that the iPhone is going to capture better audio over here, but yeah, again, you guys let me know about the audio in the comment section down below. Now if you ask what's the purpose of this video, the purpose of this video is to show you guys that you do not need a dedicated expensive camera. If you are starting out your social media journey or your social media page, then you can be happy with an iPhone. iPhones are very good for photos as well as videos. I said this in my iPhone 13 camera review as well, that it's a very well balanced camera. If you're serious about your photography and if you want to do professional work, then you can buy a dedicated camera. But if you just want a good camera for photos and videos for social media, then I'm gonna say stick with the iPhone. That's my honest opinion and that's the takeaway from this video. So anyway, this was a very interesting and quick video about the iPhone 13 versus Sony A7C. Do let me know how you feel about this video in the comment section down below. If you like this content, go ahead and that like button, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. My name is Harsh Punjabi and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.